Dear students and friends, in this video I am going to explain about friction clutches. The clutches define something like this. The clutch is a mechanical device which is used to connect or disconnect the source of power from the remaining parts of the power transmission system at the will of the operator. For example, if you take the automobile, in the automobile case, the operator is the driver. Using the clutch, driver can engage or disengage the engine from the gearbox while shifting the gears. So that is the purpose of using clutch. These clutches are classified into different types based on the number of contact surfaces. These are classified as single disc clutch and multi disc clutch. Depending on the shape of the friction material, these clutches are classified as disc clutch, cone clutch and centrifugal clutch or expanding shoe clutch. Now I will derive the equation for torque transmitting capacity of the single disc clutch. The dimensions of the single disc clutch are denoted as capital D is representing the outer diameter in millimeters, small d is representing the inner diameter in millimeters, then P is the intensity of pressure that you can notice here in Newton per mm square, capital P is the operating force and MT is the torque transmitting capacity in Newton millimeters. This we have to find. And mu is the coefficient of friction. To get the total operating force of the clutch and to get the total torque transmitting capacity of the clutch, consider a small element at a distance r of thickness dr as shown here. The area of this small element is 2 pi r dr. 2 pi r is the circumference, dr is the thickness, 2 pi r dr is the area. Once the area is known, intensity of pressure is known, you can get the axial force of the small element, that is area into pressure. Area is this, pressure is small p. So this is the axial force. Once the axial force is known, you can get the friction force. Just to multiply this axial force with coefficient of friction mu, then you will get the friction force. Then friction torque we can get by multiplying the friction force with distance. Here the distance is r, so that radius we can consider as distance in this case. Total operating force, if you want to find the total operating force, is this axial force. Whatever axial force you are getting for this small element, that you have to integrate from this small d by 2 to capital D by 2. These are the limits. So this equation, if you integrate, then you will get total operating force. If you integrate this equation, you will get the total torque transmitting capacity. So I'll take this equation. I'm integrating this from d by 2 to d by 2. In this equation, 2 pi is constant. Take that out of the integration, something like this. Then you will get the equation like this. You call this equation as 1. Then this is the equation for torque transmitting capacity. So we are integrating this from small d by 2 to capital D by 2. If you take the constant out of the integration, 2 pi is constant, mu is constant, then we will get the equation like this. Call this equation as equation 2. Now we will see two different criteria to find the operating force and torque transmitting capacity. First one is uniform pressure theory. Second one is uniform weight theory. First we will see the uniform pressure theory. In the uniform pressure theory, we have to assume that pressure is constant. In the case of new clutches, the intensity of pressure remains constant. In the case of worn out clutches, the wear remains constant. So that's why for new clutches, you can assume that P is constant. Now consider the total operating force equation like this. In this, we are assuming that P is constant because this is uniform pressure theory. That's why this constant you take out of the integration. It is like this now. Now integrate this r from d by 2 to d by 2. If you integrate this r, you will get r square by 2. Limits are small d by 2 to capital D by 2. It will be something like this. Now simplify this, you will get the equation like this for the operating force P. Now we will find the torque capacity. This is the equation for torque transmitting capacity. Now we have to integrate this. Take this constant term, P is constant. Take this constant term out of the integration. Now it is like this. Now integrate this r square dr, that is r cube by 3 you will get. And simplify this, the final equation will be something like this. This is the equation for torque transmitting capacity based on the uniform pressure theory. Now this is the equation for operating force. Just I am doing some modification such that torque transmitting capacity I can find with the help of operating force. For that intensity of pressure, you write like this. I am rearranging this equation like this. Instant intensity of pressure equal to 4 p by pi into d square minus d square. Now this p value I will substitute in this empty equation. Then it will be something like this. You just simplify this like this. Then you will get torque transmitting capacity final equation like this. This is the equation for torque transmitting capacity. Next we will see the uniform wear theory. Uniform wear theory is applied for worn out clutches. In the worn out clutches, the axial wear is proportional to the friction work. Friction work is proportional to friction force and rubbing velocity. That means friction force is mu p, rubbing velocity is 2 pi rn. So here n is also constant, that's why it is proportional to mu is constant, 2 pi is constant, n is also constant, it's proportional to p into r. Wear is proportional to p into r. Uniform wear criteria means PR is equal to constant. So that is the condition here. PR is constant, that means product of intensity of pressure and distance from center to the elemental area is constant, means if you take the inner edge, in the inner edge R is less, that means P is maximum. This product must be constant, that's why R is less means P will be maximum. If R is maximum means P will be minimum. That means at the outer edge P will be minimum. So we will take the maximum pressure case, that means R is less. R is less means R value is d by 2, small d by 2. R is more means R value is capital d by 2. Those are our limits. So that's why PR value you can take as PA into d by 2, where PA is the maximum intensity of pressure. D by 2 is the smallest distance. This is the maximum intensity of pressure or intensity of pressure at the inner edge. Now in place of this P into R, you can write PA into D by 2, and there is a constant, that's why take this out of the integration. Take this out of the integration like this. In this place you can write PA into D by 2. Now do the integration and simplify this. Now you, after integration it will be like this, and substitute the values and simplify this, it is something like this. The final equation for operating force P equal to something like this. This is the final equation. Now for torque transmitting capacity, now this is the equation. Here P R square is there. P into R, you take one particular value P into R out of the integration, and one more R remains here. P into R I am taking out of the integration. In that place I am substituting PA into D by 2. Then one more R will remain inside this integration part. Now do the integration. Now simplify this. After simplification you will get the final equation something like this. Okay. Further, if you want to simplify this equation by substituting the PA value, PA value you can get something like this from the operating force by rearranging the operating force equation. Now substitute this value here. Here you are having the term d square minus d square. This you can write as d plus d into d minus d. This d minus d gets cancelled, and final value will get it something like this. This is the equation for torque transmitting capacity in the uniform wear criteria. Now we'll solve a simple problem in single plate clutches. The problem is something like this. A plate clutch consists of a pair of contacting surfaces. The inner and outer diameters of the friction discs are 100 mm and 200 mm respectively. The coefficient of friction is 0.2 and the permissible intensity of pressure is 1 Newton per mm square. Assuming the uniform pressure and wear criteria, calculate the power transmitting capacity of the clutch at 750 rpm. Now after reading the problem, extract the given data. Given data is something like this. Inner diameter is given, outer diameter is given, coefficient of friction is given, intensity of pressure is given, that is 1 Newton per mm square, and speed is given. This speed you can use to find the power. Based on the uniform pressure theory, so this is the equation to find the operating force, and this is the equation to find the torque transmitting capacity. Once the torque is known, or torque means moment is known, you can get the power by using the very popular equation, that is 2 pi n mt by 60 into 10 power 6 we are using to get it directly in kilowatts. Okay, now substitute all these values, all the D, capital D, small d, PA, all are given. Substitute and find out the P value. P value will be like this. Find the empty value. This is moment. Once moment is known, you can get power. This is based on uniform pressure theory. Then we will see the uniform wear theory. In uniform wear theory, these are the equations to find the operating force, moment, or torque transmitting capacity. This is to calculate the power. Now we will get the answers like this. This is power. Now observe, in uniform wear theory, we are getting less power. That means when the clutch is worn out, automatically the power transmitting capacity of the clutch decreases. That you can observe here. In the previous case, the power is 28.79 kilowatts. In this case, the power is 18.51 kilowatts. Okay, it is decreased.